Morning.
Good morning. It's my pleasure to be here today. I'm James Teitsma, the MLA for Radisson. I'm proud to be here and to be part of a government that takes a keen focus on public safety. We're a government that's motivated by keeping Manitobans safe. I have a few introductions to make. We have Manitoba's Minister of Infrastructure, the Honourable Ron Schuler, with us. We also have the Minister of Justice, Cliff Cullen, the Minister of Crown Services, Colleen Mayer, and representatives from Manitoba Public Insurance, Winnipeg Police Service, and the RCMP as follows. First, there's Chris Moore from D Division Traffic Services of the RCMP. Gord Spado, who's an inspector with the Winnipeg Police Traffic Division. Ward Keith, who's Vice President of Business Development and the Chief Administrative Officer of MPI. And Satvir Jatana, who is the Vice President responsible for communications at MPI. We all know that distracted driving causes far too many accidents in our province. And as a father with children who are driving and with passengers on the roadways, I believe it's integral that it's very important that action is taken to eliminate distracted driving in our province. So to make the announcement today, I now invite Minister Schuler to the podium.
Thank you very much. Good morning. Thank you all for being here. And I'd like to thank law enforcement for taking time out of their busy day. I'd like to thank my two fellow ministers. Thank you very much for being here, and always for MPI. We want to thank MPI in particular for having compiled statistics. Before we get into the formal part, it was numbers that were provided to us by Manitoba Public Insurance Corporation that convinced myself as minister and our government that we needed to deal with distracted driving. And if you would allow me, I'm going to start off this press conference by reading a few of those numbers. Distracted driving, 2012, there were 4,780 collisions involving distracted driving. That's 2012. By 2017, that number grew to 15,403. If you want to compare that to impaired driving, same time frame, 2012 to 2017. 2012, there were 123 collisions due to impaired driving. In 2017, there were 133. It went up by 10, whereas with distracted driving, it went up threefold. Ladies and gentlemen, I believe we all know we have a problem in our society with distracted driving. With Manitoba Public Insurance recently releasing their 2017 traffic collision report, showing that distracted driving is once again the lead contributing factor responsible for 41% of fatal and 42% of serious injury collisions on our roads. 30 people lost their lives and 184 people were seriously hurt last year because of distracted driving. Distracted driving is any activity that diverts a driver's attention from the road. Distracted driving reduces awareness and increases the risk of collision by nearly four times. In June of this year, the Manitoba government passed Bill 17, known as the Drivers and Vehicles Amendment and Highway Traffic Amendment Act. We are here today to announce that as of November 1st, 2018, the legislation sets up clear consequences for distracted driving, which I will talk about including, but I want to be very clear. As of November 1st, we will be proclaiming this legislation. It will be law. Thus, everything we talk about will now be in effect. And that includes, if you are caught distracted driving, license suspension of 3 days the first time a driver is caught using an electronic communication device while driving. The suspension will increase to 7 days for subsequent occurrences within a 10-year time frame. To be very clear, if within that 10-year time frame you are caught twice, The first time will be a 3-day suspension, and thereafter it'll be 7-day. With that, the driver will be required to immediately surrender their driver's license at roadside. Officers will issue a temporary driving permit at roadside, delaying the start of the suspension until the end of the next day. So it'll be approximately 24 to 48 hours before the suspension kicks in. The temporary permit will enable a suspended driver to drive lawfully and safely to another location. The temporary permit ensures that valuable policing resources will not be spent waiting at roadside while a suspended driver finds a way to get home or to work, or if they're hauling livestock or those kinds of situations, the individuals will be allowed to get home or get their livestock off the road, and thus we will save a lot of time. An additional control measure will require officers charging a driver with careless driving to immediately notify Manitoba Public Insurance to review the driver's record in order to determine if further penalties may be required. The Manitoba government is also increasing preset fines for the use of an electronic communication device while driving from the current $203, it will be now $672 for every time you get caught on your handheld electronic device. Also, we're going to increase the demerits for careless driving from 2 to 5 demerits. To be very clear, you will now get a fine of $672 and 5 demerits on top of having your license suspended. Law enforcement uses both of these offenses to capture distracted driving, so these charges will provide tougher penalties. I'd also like to add that when you want to get your license back, there's a $50 reinstatement fee you have to pay as well. And if anybody here in the media wants to give me their where they are in their merit and demerit scale, because I take it you've all seen this in your driver's license, it's not just 5 demerits. It's not just a 3-day suspension. It's not just a $672 fine. There will be an impact on your license as well. This is going to be very, very expensive. We want to make the case to the public. The amount of accidents, and I read to you the growth from 2012 to 2017, but it's every year, and I could read to you the numbers every year. It's growing exponentially as compared to any other accident. And we have to deal with this. And folks, driving in this morning, I stopped at every light and I looked around. And it would be really easy if it was young people, you know, a 17-year-old in the vehicle on their cell phone. It's not. It's all of us. It's every demographic listening right now. It's every one of us. And it doesn't seem to matter, male, female, it doesn't matter what age it is, it doesn't seem to matter. We all have to take this serious. It's not cool being on your phone and driving. It's just not cool. And that's a message for our demographic, it's a message for the younger demographic, it's a message for all of us. I'd like to thank you, the media, because you are very important in this. And really what this is about is safety. It's protecting our loved ones, our families, our friends, our neighbors, those that mean something to us. We want to protect all Manitobans, and this is a very important measure. We are one of the leaders in the country in what we're doing here. We hope that we will see that curve come way down as people realize that there are now going to be serious consequences. One of our law enforcement officers, and I don't know if I'm allowed to usurp your thunder, but they're close to 1,000 tickets already this year. And that's just for hand-operated electronic devices. So, ladies and gentlemen, it is serious. We hope that you understand from the kind of measures we've put into place that your government takes it serious. We want to make sure that safety is our number one factor when we talk about driving on our roads and our highways. So thank you to the media for being here. We appreciate you covering this. We've got to get that message out there. We better let people know, starting November the 1st, it's going to be a little bit more expensive if you get caught with your cell phone in your hand. And I'll turn it over to James, and then we'll do some questions.
Thank you very much, Minister Schuler. Appreciate the depth of the issue and the light that you've shone on it. This does conclude this morning's announcement, and now there will be an opportunity for the media to ask questions of the cabinet ministers and the representatives from Winnipeg Police, RCMP, and from MPI. So I'll turn it over to them. Thank you.
Questions?
Hey, good morning. I truly believe that it's just the cultural dynamic that we have right now. People are so accustomed to instant communication, instant contact, instant gratification for everything. And people don't understand that when you take your attention away from what you're supposed to be doing, how dangerous that truly is. And I think the message that's being passed on by government right now is, it's time to get the message, it's dangerous, and we need it to stop. Yes and no. Basically, this now brings it on par with careless driving, and truly it is. It's a form of careless driving. It's just something that is easily identifiable and very narrow scope. But it really is on a par with careless driving, so the penalties should be similar. Nothing specific comes to mind unless you take a look at the video that we put out in April. Sergeant Rob Duchin had a very personal experience with this, where his dad was killed by a distracted driver who was on their cell phone. And if you ever get a chance to watch that video, it's on our YouTube channel. It's very, very impactful. I actually am looking at putting it out again on our Twitter feed. It really hits home to what this is all about, that no life is worth that tweet or that email or that phone call. It's just not worth it, and it's time that we see some change in behavior. Our goal really would be to issue zero tickets and zero license suspensions, because that would mean that people are getting the message. As the minister alluded to, we have significant numbers. I'll just make one correction. That $1,000 or 1,000 ticket number is what we're on pace for the month of October alone. July, we ran a distracted driving program. We had over 900 tickets for July. People aren't getting the message, and hopefully with this change in legislation, people start to get that message.
Further questions? Yes, you go in front of the registrar and chances are you lose your license. Again, it's an independent officer, so we don't direct what happens, but it goes to Ward Keith's department. And do you want to walk us through just what happens in that process? They get notified and we'll have Ward explain that.
Sure, so under the new legislation, the roadside suspensions are what are administered by the police, as the minister indicated. So that's three days for a first suspension and 7 days for a second or subsequent, anytime within that 10-year window. But the reality is that upon conviction, all convictions are also reported to Manitoba Public Insurance and are added to the driving record. And when things get added to the driving record, then that triggers a review by our Driver Improvement and Control Department, which is operated under the Registrar of Motor Vehicles. The intent of that whole program is to get ahead of risky driving behavior before it actually results in collisions and fatalities and serious injuries. So if somebody has multiple convictions for one of these offenses, or has even one conviction conviction for a careless driving conviction under this new legislation, that will immediately trigger a notice to the Registrar of Motor Vehicles, who will review the entirety of the driving record and, if necessary, take further action, which could include temporary or permanent driver license suspension.
So this could cost you a lot of money and you lose your license. That venue is open, they can go to court and challenge any ticket. That is correct. That is correct. No, we're focusing in on that because that is the main thing. Distracted driving is eating a pizza, drinking a Coke, and doing something else. I mean, it could be unsecured pet on your lap. It can be a whole bunch of things. Distracted driving is any of those things which distracts you from what you should be doing is driving. And as our vehicles get more and more comfortable, as they get nicer, you know, we feel like we're sitting in our living room, and often our vehicle is like our living room. It's as comfortable, but it's not. You're driving a very heavy, very dangerous piece of equipment that can very easily kill. And so it includes just a myriad of things. And obviously you're over the white line, officer can see what's going on, pulls you over, and that's part of distracted driving. And that gets captured. If you're driving distracted, everything qualifies. It comes down to the officer can see that you're not engaged in driving, and they can see that you're distracted. Further questions? No. Not at this time. It doesn't contemplate that. Well, concerning they've given out 1,000 tickets this month, I think they're doing really good. Are you planning on putting more officers on the road for November? I'll allow RCMP.
Actually, our distracted driving enhanced enforcement is happening this month. I believe the RCMP are doing their enhanced enforcement through November. And these are things that are funded from MPI. And we had 3 dedicated months to distracted driving this year alone.
Okay. RCMP?
And we won't be changing our enforcement numbers, but obviously these behaviors contribute to fatalities across the province, and we're going to contribute to make our roads safer for all Manitobans. So far this year for distracted driving, we're just over 1,000 in RCMP jurisdictions.
Okay. Further questions? If none? Okay, yes. Okay, so for this topic, we are basically done. Thank you very much. And I want to say to you, the media, you have a very important role in this to get that message out, because we are losing far too many of our loved ones, our fellow Manitobans, with very risky behavior. Thank you for covering this, and appreciate you getting the message out, because November the 1st is going to be very, very shocking for a lot of people. You had your hand. It is already part of the part of the graduated licensing. Distracted driving is part of that. That's why a lot of the focus isn't necessarily young people, because they're already getting it messaged as they're getting their license. It's the rest of us who sort of got used to it. You know, that culture thing? The rest of us have to change our behavior as well. So thank you for the question. Thanks, folks, and we'll leave, and I believe Minister of Justice will stay for the next part.